The 11 News I team uncovers some new questions tonight that stem from that big prison corruption case made public yesterday.
Yeah, the allegations are really shocking, but prison officials have known for years about the trouble within their jails. I team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live in the newsroom with the latest. Jane.
Donna, the allegations of corrections officers having sex and children with inmates certainly sets this case apart. But the influence of gangs in prison and their ability to corrupt has a lot of history.
In April of 2009, city police broke up an unusual meeting in Druid Hill Park of the violent drug gang known as the Black Gorilla Family. Bold of them to meet so publicly, but brazen behavior is part of the gang's DNA. Yesterday, federal prosecutors accused gang members of literally getting in bed with corrections officers to run a lucrative drug operation inside the city's jails. It's but the latest case exposing the prison system's problem. Federal wiretaps in 2009 caught phone conversations between a BGF leader at a city facility known as MTC or the Pen and a male corrections officer. The officer described how many of his co-workers were getting involved in smuggling. You know, down there are so many people who doing it, smuggling and selling contraband, you know, it's impossible to be the only one, the officer is heard to say. Now you got like 7-8 people. Soon, it's the whole damn shift. That officer was indicted in a 2009 federal drug case. Prison officials say 54 corrections employees have been fired for smuggling contraband or fraternizing with inmates since 2010. Not included, the four female corrections officers made pregnant by gang leader Tavon White after having sex with him in jail over the last several years. Prison head Gary Maynard responding to questions yesterday.
It's grounds for termination if there is a relationship between correctional staff and the offenders.
Were these women fired?
Pardon?
Were these women fired? The ones who are...
No.
They're in your institution having sex with the inmates.
Right.
Were they fired?
No.
Federal agents found that union rules tie the hands of prison officials, and prison employees know it. Nothing new about that either. Those 2009 wiretaps caught a female corrections employee telling an inmate, "It takes a lot to bring me up on the smallest stuff. I got the union behind me."
Prison spokesman said today the female officers charged in this case are now on their way to possible termination. The governor's office says the governor has full confidence in his public safety secretary. Reporting live tonight from the newsroom, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.